Hello friends, in this video we will learn how to install Radar 10 in Windows 10 using virtual machine. I have many questions about how to install Radar 10 in Windows 10. So please watch this video till the end to understand complete process. So let's start and learn something new. Friends, as in my first video, that is how to install Radar 10. I have told you that Radar is a 32-bit operating system, so it does not function properly in 64-bit operating system. So what we will do, we will make certain changes into our system of 64-bit to make it compatible for Radar. To make it compatible, we need to have two things into our computer: VirtualBox, Windows 8.1 32-bit ISO file. You have to download and install VirtualBox from the official website of virtualbox.org and ISO file, which you can download from the official site of Microsoft, or other sites are also available in the internet. Select the edition, confirm, choose language, confirm, download 32-bit operating system. Now, once you have installed the virtual machine, its icon will come onto your desktop. Open it, click on New. Give the name for this system. As I am installing Windows 8.1, so I will write Win 8.1. You can give any name, there is no restriction. Select the folder where you want to install it. I am installing in my E drive. You can install anywhere. The minimum size required is around 40 GB. Don't change here. Now select Windows 8.1 32-bit. Next, select the size of RAM to be allocated to the virtual machine. You can go up to less than 50% of your original RAM. The recommended size is 1 GB. I am selecting up to 1 GB. Click on Next. Create a virtual hard disk. The recommended size is 40 GB. Next, choose the virtual file type as VDI. Next, select the file location and size of virtual hard disk. Recommended size is 40 GB. This size is fixed once you select, so you can go up to high. Click on Create. Here you can see we have created new virtual machine. Before we go to start, we will set some settings here. Bidirectional, system, uncheck floppy, pointing device as USB multi touch tablet, storage, click on empty. Now click on CD icon to choose a disk file. Here select your ISO file which you have pre-downloaded. Click on open. Sometimes when you set the settings, you will see some error displayed here. I will show that. This error is displayed here saying invalid settings for virtualization in acceleration mode. And the OK button will be disabled here. That means you have to correct the error first, then you can proceed. I will show you how to correct that error. For that, restart your computer and go to BIOS of that computer. To enter into BIOS menu, every computer model has different function key, but mostly it is F10. In Dell, it is F12. So as soon as the logo of the model appears, start pressing F10 or F2 key several times till you enter into BIOS menu. Now use right, left, upper and downward arrow key to make changes. Go to Security and then System Security. If this option virtualization is disabled, then you will get this error. So make it to enable. Enter F10 to save and exit. After this process, the error message will vanish. Now again do all settings as I explained you before and then click on OK. Now click on Start. Again select the ISO file and start. Select the language, install. The ISO file I have downloaded is not pre-activated, so it is asking for product key. You will get product key from Google. If you download pre-activated ISO file, then it will not ask for product key. Take any product key and type here to activate. Now click on next. Accept the license and click on next. Custom install, next. Your new Windows is installing. It is a lengthy process, so have patience and follow the steps. It's done. Now Windows will restart. Don't click anywhere. This will take some time. This will take some more time, so I am forwarding the video. Give a name to your PC and follow all these steps. Select settings according to you. Write username and click on finish. So the desktop is ready to install Radar 10. Now you can directly download Radar 10 files here from my video. Click on I button above to watch that video. Now we will copy Radar 10 files from main host PC to this guest PC. As this is guest PC, so you cannot copy or drag and drop directly from host PC. For this, go to device option, click on insert guest edition CD image. Then install it. Install this one. Reboot now. Create a new folder in the desktop, rename it as shared. Go to properties of this folder, sharing, click on share, select everyone and add. Click on read and write, share, done, close it. In guest PC, go to devices, shared folders. Click on plus icon, select folder path, select folder, make permanent, OK. Now you can share your files and folders through this path. Open this folder in host PC. In guest PC, go to network, open this. You can see the shared folder is available. Open it. Whatever changes you make in any one of these, automatically changes will be there in others. So now paste your Radar 10 installer file here. Refresh here. These are the installer files. Cut this folder and paste it into desktop. It will take some time depending on the size of the file. Now open this folder. Install Radar 10 part 01. Install. So the Radar 10 and Encyclopedia Homeopathica icons are there in the desktop now. Don't run Radar 10 now, otherwise an error will come like this. First, delete Radar 10 config file from desktop and restart the system. Now go to Radar 10 folder and follow these steps carefully. Double click, back, double click. Now minimize this and open Radar 10 from desktop. Select the repository ShrewNF Synthesis 9.0. So finally, Radar 10 is successfully installed. Now we will check Encyclopedia. If this error comes, don't worry. Go to Radar folder again, open the properties of autorec.exe file, click on compatibility and change the compatibility mode from Service Pack 2 to Service Pack 3. Change settings for all users. Here also do the same thing. Apply, OK. Apply, OK. Now double click on it. Yes. And now open Encyclopedia Homeopathica. Yes, this is also installed correctly. So in this lengthy video, we have learned many important things. I have shortened the video, otherwise it would have been very long video. Please give your valuable comments if you like this video. If you have any queries, you can ask your queries in the comment section of this video. I will try to answer all of you. Thank you.